Aloha everybody, Kaiwaza with you. Welcome back to my channel, and true to course with what's been happening lately is that every time I finally decide I'm going to record a video, multitudinous other people decide they're going to do things in that exact same moment. So my neighbors across the way have decided to go out on their lanai and start singing their laments horribly off key at a loud volume, and then other people have decided now is a great time to go down into their parking structure, which is right outside my apartment, and kind of visit with each other very loudly. So that's what's happening. I do actually live in a quiet neighborhood. You would never know it from my videos recently, but I do. But, you know, what are you going to do? I'm just, the only way to go is forward, so we're going forward. So today I'm doing some more mood music, easy listening record haul. This one, again, probably is going to be in two, well, it is going to be in two parts. And we're going to take a look at records that I picked up that I would be using for my radio station Moody Mood Music, which is an easy listening, kind of old school easy listening station online on live365.com, and the link for that will be below if you want to check that out. But I like to haul videos, I haul records, and then I will listen to them, spot listen to all of them, so I, you know, I have some idea of what they are, so we can talk about them a little bit. I love to look at records and just looking at them, but I kind of dislike when people do hauls just showing you records and that they haven't listened to, so they can't really say anything about it. It's just like, here it is, and you go, well, okay, that's cool. What about it? Anyway, so that's what I'm doing. So let's just get started. And I should say this is a combined haul, really, from three places. I went to, this is from Goodwill, from Savers Thrift Store. And then also this past weekend, one of my coworker friends decided that she wanted to go to Aloha Swap Meet, Aloha Stadium Swap Meet, which I haven't been to in years and years because it's a hefty long trip on public conveyance to get out there. But she has a car and she was wanting to go and just asked if I wanted to go along. So I did. And somebody was selling a bunch of records and I got a bunch. And I actually would have gotten a bunch more probably at probably some other vendors that had them. But I got all these records and then we were very close to the car where we parked the car. And I'm like, let me just take these back to the car. And we did, and she discovered at that point that the battery was dead. So we had to get, you know, had to get a jump, and that was the end of the shopping. I mean, obviously she had to go to the shop and whatever. So maybe I'll go again at some point, but I did score some stuff. So let's take a look at what majority of what I'm going to show you did come, actually, the majority from the Aloha Stadium Swap Meet. So let's take a look at what I got for Moody Mood Music. Do not hate when I show you this record, but I just could not resist this one. I mean, and it was only a dollar. Anita Bryant, The Miracle of Christmas. If you don't remember who Anita Bryant is, then I'll just spare you. I just had to get it, and we could feature this on Moody Mood Music during the Christmas season because it's very appropriate and easy listening and all of that, so. Yeah, Anita Bryant. It just makes me laugh to look at that. Okay, I got this one, RCA Camden, The Best of Living Voices, great love songs. You know, the living voices are ever so much better than the near-dead voices or the comatose voices. I love the nudity here and sort of nudity. And then the back's a little bit more scandalous, but it's a smaller picture. But, you know, living voices, that's great fodder for the easy listening station. Love it. This one, Dick Powell, Love is in the Air Tonight. This is from Collectibles series. This is a reissue, of course, of a lot of very early, earlier stuff by him. He's a one of the big band vocalist kind of guys. You can kind of get the time era from this picture on the back. I love this picture.
Better look your coziest nook up. Each station throughout the nation will have a song coming through.
And these are just, you know, reissues of music of his that probably, you know, most of it would have been on 78s. Or maybe 45s, too. Well, here's a group that, kind of a nice group for easy listening, the Mills Brothers. I do have some of their stuff. Such Sweet Singing.
We could hear the voices ringing. They seem to say...
This is Vocalion. I didn't really quite notice it when I bought it, which was kind of the budget label of Decca. So most likely this is... like a compilation of some things they did earlier that they just reissue more cheaply. Now here's a true budget record. I like to get I like to get any budget record. I'm just interested in budget records, particularly, especially easy listening. And I also always get budget label soundtrack recreations. This is the Diplomat Records. And the Fiddler on the Roof, but not the, you know, Broadway or the movie or whatever. This is like their own. Al Goodman and his orchestra with vocals by Philip Golden and Martha Gary. Boy, that Martha Gary, she's a favorite.
Now is the little boy a bride.
I sort of like the idea of, I do program budget label soundtracks also on Moody Mood Music, and true to the original records, I sort of like the idea of, you know, people probably listening to it and going, oh, that song, oh yeah, that's from, you know, Fiddler on the Roof, and listening to it and being sort of like, that's not the right guy though, is it? Like, I don't know. Well, here's somebody I got. I actually picked up three of his records. Love his voice, don't have much of his stuff, and want to, you know, get more of it. I've always liked him. And that's Jerry Vale. The late Jerry Vale was an Italian-American and kind of really billed as an Italian-American singer. Love his voice, and I do love the records of his that I've had, so I do pick up other ones when I see them, and I've gotten three.
That what was wrong can be right. Every night I'll sleep now, no more lies, things that I promised myself.
Where's the playground, Susie? Oh. Looks like you're at a sports field, so I don't think that's the playground, but...
And it's all because you're near me.
I like this cover. You don't have to say you love me. Nice voice, right? I mean, I guess not for everybody, but I like him. Can't go wrong with the Ray Charles Chorus. This is one of this I think is their first solo, their first album as a solo act, rather than backing somebody else up, April in Paris. I love the picture, like, what is this? Like, yes, here's a person, you know, passed out on the sidewalk. While looking at the flowers, I don't know.
From a shadow, I start getting restless when
I... Can't go wrong with the Ray Charles Chorus. By the way, Ray Charles, the reference in here is not the Ray Charles that we know of in America. Ray Charles was an English, you know, orchestra and choral leader. Okay. Not the other Ray Charles. Here's a budget label one. Again, I do like to pick up the budget labels if I don't have them. Best of Old Broadway by by people you've never heard of before, and the Lou Raymond Orchestra. They don't even list the vocalists on the cover or on the back of this one, but they do list it on the album. That's a nice refreshing change. Gene Merlino, Joe Milano, Doris Drew, I don't know these people, John Gustafson, and Tommy Trainer, and one that you might know, I know, who later on was quite famous for being on the Lawrence Welk show for many years, and that is Norma Zimmer, known on Lawrence Welk as the Champagne Lady. Now here's a record I was actually really excited to see. I'm like, I want to hear this one. It's a choral group, which I'm really glad to always find choral groups. I need more and more of them. It's called Surprise, a happy new sound, a joyous new beat. It's music making splashed with youth. It's the Glad Singers. And they are glad with, I don't know, Florence Henderson or Goldie Hawn or somebody in that genre of look. Here on the cover, so glad. This is a great record. This is the choral. It's kind of like, I would compare them very much to Ray Conniff, but like Ray Conniff, but more edgier, a little more intense. Really cool. I like these guys.
Surprise, 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 surprise.
Surprise.
Hello, everyone. I'm so relaxed and stress-free now. Why, you ask? Because I've tuned into moody mood music, and I'm enjoying the sounds of my fellow easy listening records. Such lovely, lush, beautiful sounds from decades past surely can relieve the stress and discomfort of anyone. Please join me at Moody Mood Music. The link is to be found below in the description box. Perhaps I'll have a cocktail.
Now, in one of my recent previous haul videos, I had come across an album by the Johnny Mann Singers, Volume 2, and I thought, well, that must mean there's a Volume 1. Wouldn't it be great to find it? And lo and behold, at the swap meet, there was Volume 1. Johnny Mann Singers, Golden Folk Song Hits.
Long time passing, where have all the flowers gone? Long time ago, where have all the flowers gone? Young girls.
Johnny Mann also, singers are quite, you know, dependable, reliable to do some good, kind of easy listening stuff. Okay, here's a budget label. This is really, truly a budget label, and you know I love my budget labels so much. I can't even tell you. I saw this cover and was like, this is beautiful. Even the guy that was selling them was like, look at that cover. Like, yeah, what is it? I love it. Tiara Records, Connie Haines singing Showboat Favorites. I saw this picture. There's a couple things that are funny about this record. I saw this picture. Well, number one, who the F is Connie Haines, right? That was my, because usually a budget label will feature an artist that's very well known, and they'll get like one or two tracks of them singing very early in their career, like garage recordings or something. and they'll get the rights to like a couple songs like that, smack it on an album saying Connie Haines singing, and it'll be like two or three songs from her and then a bunch of instrumental orchestra stuff or other singers or somebody that sounds kind of like Connie Haines or somebody else singing songs that Connie Haines actually did sing in their own versions. So I was like, who is Connie Haines? So I had to look that up, but she was a big band singer with a couple of different outfits. And so she did have a, you know, career singing. I wouldn't say she was mega super famous, but famous enough that there were some recordings of hers that they got a hold of and could release an album. When I saw the picture, I was like, that looks kind of familiar. She looks sort of familiar to me. And I was thinking of one of my Hawaiian records. Like, I thought, could she? I don't think she would have been a model on that, but this Vacations in Hawaii by the Hawaiians, which is a budget label. When I first saw it, I thought, I wonder if that's her, like, and it isn't, I'm quite sure, but they're very similar coloring, like the pictures, their facial features are sort of similar, and what I noticed when I got at home and kind of had to laugh is that their body position is very similar, which may be what made me think that too, because I just have this picture of this lady beating on the tom-tom, and she's out there with her arms kind of like that, you know, too, and I just thought it was amusing. But anyway, what's really funny about this record is there are, like, the first three or four songs are by Connie Haines, and then the rest of the album is by some guy singing, and I put it on side two, just randomly when I was listening to parts of it, and the first thing I heard was this guy singing, and I was looking at her and listening to the voice and looking at her. I'm like, have I misgendered this person? Or does Connie... And then I played the other side and realized the first three or four songs were Connie Haines. And then I thought, well, you know, did she undergo a transformation? Is this her pre and post? I mean, I don't know. Is she, you know, is she... Maybe she's not... Maybe Connie Haines is non-binary person and has the ability to sing a wide range, you know, of... vocal stylings. I know that alone was just kind of funny on this record to put it on, and you hear clearly a male singing and going, Connie Haines. They usually wouldn't do that. The budget labels at least would usually have another woman singing or just instrumentals. But yeah, Tiara, real bottom of the barrel label. Love it. Love it, love it. So the last one I have for today. Sorry, somebody was messaging me and I was trying to get it out of the screen and it got all messed up. It's so annoying when people message you when you're trying to film. It's like, I have to put on the Do Not Disturb or something, don't I? I never do. Anyway, Dave Brubeck Quartet. Of course, this is a jazz group, but it's Bossa Nova, USA. And if anything is beautiful on a beautiful music station, it's Bossa Nova. So this was really nice. I checked this one out and yeah, very much kind of what you would expect. Okay, that's my first half of my haul and we will stop there and I'll film the rest another time soon. So I hope you enjoyed that. Any comments, please leave them below. Happy to hear from you. And once again, check out the station, Moody Mood Music or Hawaiian Hi-Fi, if you're interested in either one. And yeah, have a good one. I'll see you next time. Take care. With royal beauty bright.